I'm Natalie Kenway, Global Head of ESG Insight at ESG Clarity. For this video interview, I'm speaking to Christophe Girondeau, Head of Institutional and Wholesale Distribution at Nordea. We're going to be discussing the firm's STARS range, which has 14 billion euros in assets under management. These invest in equities and bonds with an ESG overlay integrated into the investment process. Thank you so much for joining me, Christophe.
Thank you, Natalie, for having me.
Right, so can you tell me, give me an overview of the STARS range and its evolution over the past decade?
Yeah, so the STARS range was created around 10 years ago with our Emerging STARS products. That was the first one in the range. And the idea at that time was we believed that integrating ESG in the way you manage money, in the way you invest, would be help you to discover the stars of tomorrow. And that's why you have the name STARS. So the idea was the stars of tomorrow will take into account the ESG element. So that's what we did at that time. Then, you know, it has grown a lot. We have around 17 products today that follow the same concept where we try to beat the benchmark, and it's a common benchmark. It's not, you know, a special benchmark. That was very important because we believe that the ESG allows us to do that. The second topic is obviously you need to have a certain level of ESG. So we have our own proprietary model and we decide, you know, is the company eligible or not to that type of portfolio. And finally, we wanted to create a lasting impact with that product. And that really comes to engagement. So if you think about it, you know, the real distinctive feature we have in our way to approach ESG is this integration of our ESG analyst into the investment team. So even if they have different reporting line for obvious reason, they really work with the portfolio manager, they make proposal to the portfolio manager, so they're really working in symbiosis. So it's really one, it's not two team, it's one team. And I think that makes, I think, a big difference in the way we look at this product compared to what you have seen. And that has led us at the end of the day to move all our fundamental equity strategies to this process. So we don't have a non-ESG fundamental equity product, we only have ESG fundamental equities. So that has been basically the evolution over time that we have actually been going through with our STARS product range.
Okay, great, thank you. And the STARS range, it's, as I mentioned, investing across equities and bonds and across a range of different regional equities as well. Which areas have been seeing stronger inflows recently? I know that obviously lots of ESG funds or strategies have been seeing higher inflows over this past year, but are there any in particular that have seen increased flows?
Mm-hmm. So the very interesting thing is, over the last years, we have seen a lot of money into thematic ESG. I think we also benefited from this with our more thematic ESG product. But since the SFDR has been starting to be discussed in the industry, we have seen much more interest in our STARS range, which is, you know, more building block product. And so now the range is around 16 billion. So it has grown since last year. And so you see this trend with the SFDR that people want to build model portfolios instead of, you know, going just for a thematic, and that we have benefited a lot from. So you see our emerging stars, I mean, the one that has 10 years has got quite a lot of money, but also, for example, North American stars, which is something, you know, quite different. And there is not a lot of asset managers that do a real ESG work on the US because of obvious reason, you know, Trump. And so, and here we have benefited from the fact that we have a longer track on this. And now, you know, more recently, the fixed income side start also to be interesting. So our high yield, European high yield bond stars have also seen quite significant flows. So you see, it's very diverse. And it's really very much around this trend that you need to build a model portfolio and therefore you need building blocks and therefore you're going to look at what is available in the market. And given our history, obviously we have a bit of an advantage here.
That's a really interesting shift, what you mentioned about SFDR there. I've noticed that stories we've covered on ESG Clarity on SFDR have been very, very popular. And yes, the range, STARS range, recently moved into bonds as well as equities. How challenging has it been to find ESG compliant bonds within that area? And are there any particular areas that have been focused on?
So it's obviously a bit more complex on the bond side because your portfolio is much more issuer, so much more bonds compared to an equity, you know, concentrated fundamental equity portfolio. So it's much more work. So here our proprietary model plays a big role to be able to screen the bonds and look at ESG. So that's the first thing. The second thing is when you look at bonds, you have idiosyncratic risk. So basically you have an uncapped loss where you have a capped return. So you need to look very much at the risk. So the ESG is super important when you analyze the risk. And therefore on the credit side, that plays a big role because, you know, that helps you to avoid some fat tail event that could, you know, hit a company. So that's a very important element of our process when you look at our high yield product, for example. So the risk element is actually quite important here. Finally, you also have development on the sovereigns. So we did quite a lot of work with our portfolio manager that has been working well on emerging debts to try to hear. You need really to find out what are the risks that you see on the different countries and what are the risks that you could avoid by having a strong ESG element. Engagement is a bit more difficult, but it's also possible. You know, we did it on Brazil, where I think that has been also covered in the press. So clearly, there is also a possibility to engage with as a debt holder with some sovereigns or some companies. So it's still developing, so it's new compared to what you see on equity, but I think it's moving quite fast as well.
So looking at the wider responsible investment industry, what are the key ESG trends do you expect to see over the coming decade?
I think, you know, we just have SFDR implemented. So the truth is, in Europe at least, this is a big driver of what is going to happen because the SFDR is just the start of a journey. You see, you have a lot of new regulation coming. We just had some information from the Commission, especially on the MiFID implementation of sustainability. Yeah. I don't think, you know, everybody realized, but, you know, in 1 year's time, you will need to ask your clients about these sustainability preferences. And we have a massive work to do because a lot of the advisors have never been educated on sustainability. So how can they, you know, discuss sustainability preferences with their clients if they have not been educated? So here there is a massive work. I think that is going to occupy a lot of the distributors in the coming weeks and months. And I think we want, as an asset manager, to be part of that. We want to help them there because we think that's really a very important challenge that we all face. And in a way, it's not a choice because that's a regulation that has come to us that we have to implement. So I would say that's really what occupies me a lot for the next, maybe not decade, but the next 5 years. I think that's going to be very much on the agenda of everyone.
Yes, I'm hearing that a lot. Regulation and education seem to be some key themes. Okay, I've got one more question for you. What is your favorite sustainable drink or snack?
So favorite drink is water, actually. So that's it's a bit, you know, a bit strange, but I think at the end of the day, this is the most sustainable we have. And I think it's also something that is very close to the way we look at companies, you know, on the water management. And I think that would be my favorite drink.
Brilliant. Okay, well, thank you very much for sharing your insights with us, Christoph.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.